Hello student, welcome back. The next topic is relaxation oscillator. This is one of the application of operational amplifier. Here you can see operational amplifier is connected. In the feedback path, resistor is connected and capacitor is also connected. So now the question comes, what is oscillator? A oscillator is the device which produces oscillating signal. Either may be triangular or pulse type. In this case, we are using relaxation oscillator to produce a pulse waveform as shown in the diagram. Now, initially, the capacitor is totally discharged. Now, initially, the capacitor is totally discharged. That means the input voltage at the non-inverting terminal is zero. Definitely, the input voltage at the non-inverting terminal is higher. That means this is higher than this one. So, output will be positive, that is plus Vsat. Output will be Vsat. Now, this Vsat output voltage is fed back through resistor and our capacitor will try to recharge. And same Vsat voltage is fed back to through our resistor divider network. So now what is the voltage, reference voltage at inverting, non-inverting terminal? The reference voltage at non-inverting terminal is nothing but R2 divided by R1 plus, R1 divided by R1 plus R2, R1 plus R2 into Vsat. So that is, this component will call B. So then the reference voltage is B Vsat. So reference voltage is B Vsat. So our capacitor will charge from zero till it reaches this one, positive Vsat. When the voltage at the capacitor or voltage at this terminal is greater than this B Vsat, that means now this one will become greater than this one. That means output will be minus Vsat. Output becomes minus Vsat. When the output becomes minus Vsat, capacitor, same voltage is fed back to the capacitor and now the capacitor will discharge. So capacitor will discharge. Now what output is fed back to the inverting terminal? It is same, but it is B into minus Vsat. When the capacitor voltage goes below this one, when capacitor discharge and it goes below minus Vsat, then this voltage here at positive terminal, it becomes more higher than negative terminal. That time output will get to plus Vsat and capacitor will try to charge in the positive way. So in this way, this will repeat, charging and recharging of the capacitor repeats, and we can see the time period is nothing but this is T is nothing but on period and off period of this pulse waveform. So that is called as T. So there is a formula to find out T. T is equal to phi RC ln 1 plus B minus 1 minus B. So in the next slide, we'll see the numerical related to this one. So relaxation oscillator determine the peak to here. Here the problem is here. They determine the peak to peak amplitude and the frequency of the square wave. Saturation output voltage of the operational amplifier is plus or minus 12.5 volt. Here it is given. So here it is given. This is Vsat. Vsat is either positive this one plus 12.5 or minus 12.5 at the power supply voltages of minus plus or minus 15 volt, and you have to peak to peak amplitude you have to find out, and you have to find out the frequency of the square wave. So how to find out this frequency of the square wave? So first, how to find out this frequency of the square wave? So here you can see the feedback resistor is around 10 kilo ohm, and this is our micro this one capacitor, and these are the resistors. So first we have to find out B. So we know the formula. First we have to find out B is equal to R1 plus R2, that is R is nothing but 47 kilo ohm, and R1 plus R2 is nothing 57. So we have to find out the value of B. By using the value of B, we got the value of the B is nothing but this is 0.825. That is the value of B. Now we know the formula for the output waveform in relaxation oscillator, that is 2RC ln 1 plus B and 1 minus B. So it is so please remember, this is ln 2RC ln ln and 1 plus B and divide by 1 plus B divide by 1 minus B. That is the formula. So when you substitute this one, B we know, you will get the value 4.69 millisecond, and when you, we know frequency is 1 by T. When you calculate this one, you will get 2.13 kilohertz. We'll get 2.13 kilohertz. Now we have to find out the peak to peak amplitude of the output. How to find out the peak to peak amplitude of the output? See, this is positive Vsat and this is a negative Vsat, and this is the time, and we found out the frequency also. This is positive, that is says 12.5. So negative is also minus 12.5. So then what is the peak to peak? That peak to peak is nothing but now 25, right? So peak to peak is nothing but we will get 25. So in this way we will calculate this value. So the next one is next one in this category is a nonlinear amplifier. So we'll see now what is nonlinear amplifier. Nonlinear amplifier. What do you mean by nonlinear amplifier? Nonlinear amplifier. So far you have seen the linear amplifier. Linear amplifier means which amplify the particular signal with the particular gain. For example, if I say the 2 volt is amplified with the gain factor of 3, then it will be amplified with the gain factor of 3. So now, but in some application we need to amplify some of the frequency components with the different gain factor, and some components with different gain factor. Such type of amplifier is called as nonlinear amplifier. For example, you have seen in the music system, we have some in the music system we have So in the music system, we have some frequency component, this bass buzzer. We can vary the frequency component by varying all those. So we can particular frequency we can increase and particular frequency you can decrease. That is actually one of the application of the nonlinear amplifier. The diagram for the nonlinear amplifier is shown here. Here actually you can see the capacitor is connected in series. That means it will allow I frequency component, and diode is also connected. So now our problem statement is something like this. I have waveform, something like this. I have waveform of one is 2 volt of same frequency, other one is of higher amplitude of same frequency, higher amplitude of same frequency. I want to suppress this one and I want to amplify this low amplitude signal. I want to amplify low amplitude signal and I want to suppress this one, high amplitude, this one signal. For low amplitude signal, this diode won't be able to conduct. This diode won't be able to conduct. That means low amplitude signal, low amplitude signal frequency, and I'm talking about amplitude, not frequency. Low amplitude signal will pass through this operational amplifier and get amplified. For high amplitude signal, this diode, one of the diode will be conduct during the positive cycle, other diode conduct during the negative cycle. So the signal passes something like this. Without it means it bypasses our operation amplifier. So that is the it bypasses the operation amplifier. So by like this, I can suppress this one component. I can amplify the other component. This is called as a nonlinear amplifier. So, my dear students, we have completed all the application of our operational amplifier. With this, our operational amplifier concept is completed. The next one is called as wave shaping circuits. The wave shaping circuits you will see triple phi timer and monostable and astable multivibrator. With that, our first module will be over. Thank you.